सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् तद् अभिध्यानादेव तु तल्लिङ्गात् सह किम् इमानि वेदादीनि भूतानि स्वयमेव स्वविकारान् सृजन्ति इमानि वेदादीनि भूतानि दिस् फैव् एलिमेण्ट्स् बिगिनिङ्ग् फ्रम् वेद आर् स्पेस् किं स्वयमेव स्वविकारान् सृजन्ति दे क्रियेट् देर् ओन् मोडिफिकेशन्स् देर् ओन् प्रोडक्ट्स् देर् ओन् इफेक्ट्स् लैक् इस् इट् दि स्पेस् देट् क्रियेट्स् इण्डिपेण्डेण्ट्लि the element air, and air creates fire, and so on. Ahosvida parameshvareva tena tena atmana avadishthamana abhidhyayan tamtam vikaram sujateti. Or is it parameshvara, the paramatma, param brahma? Seva tena tena atmana avadishthamana obtaining as the very self of the space, very self of the air, very self of those respective elements. Abhidhyayan, that he meditates, he deliberates, and tam tam vikaram sujati, and he creates those particular modifications. Do these elements independently create these subsequent elements, or is the Parameshwara, obtaining as the self of those elements, he creates them? इति सन्देहे सति प्राप्तं तावत् स्वयमेव सृजन्ति इति सो वेन् दिस् डौट् अरैज़ इस् वेदर् द एलिमेण्ट्स् देम्सेल्व्स् क्रियेट्स् दि सब्सिक्वेण्ट् एलिमेण्ट्स् आर् Is it Parameshwara who does? Then Tavat Praptam, Puru Pakshi says, Swayameva Srujanteti, taking the literal meaning. Akashat Vayuhu, Vayuhu Agnihi, Agnihi Apah. The Shruti says that from space the air, from air the fire, from fire the water. There is no mention of Parameshwara here. Therefore, these statements lead us to believe that these elements themselves create the subsequent modifications. Sukuda Akashad Vayu Vaityadi Svatantra Shravanat. That Akasha, independent of Paramatma, creates Vayu, and Vayu, independent of Paramatma, creates Agni. Nanu Achetananam Svatantranam Pravruttihi Pratishiddha. But look, in the previous sutra, this was discussed. Akasha deva samutpadyante or rachana anupapatte. In that sutra, it was established that the pradhan achetanam does not have the knowledge required for what the universe is to be created, because knowledge always rests or centers on a conscious being. These elements are unconscious, therefore they cannot acknowledge, they cannot create. This has already been said. Naisha dosha, that dosha is not there, the defect is not here. Tat teja aikshada taha apa aikshanta iti cha bhutanam api chetanatva shravanada. Again, taking literally the meaning of this Shruti statement, tat teja asrujata, tat teja aikshada, that teja, the element fire, aikshada saw, deliberated. Tadapaha aikshanta, what element water also deliberated. So Shruti says that these elements deliberated, and deliberation means that they must be conscious entity. Iti bhutanavi chetanatva shravanat. Shruti herself says that these elements deliberated, therefore they are chetana, they are sentient beings. So therefore we say that these elements independent of Ishvara created the subsequent elements. Evam prapte abhidhiyate. Saiva parameshwarah tena tena atmana avatishthamanah abhidhyayan tam tam vikaram srujati iti abhidhiyate. This is what this sutrakara has to say. So tat abhidhyayan tad lingat saha. So saha eva, so tad abhidhyanat eva tad lingat, that eva kara goes with saha, sa eva parameshwarah. So although the Shruti words are not in anvaya, tad abhidhyanat eva tu tad lingat saha, saha eva, that's how. So saha eva becomes the pratignya, sa eva Parameshwarah tena tena atmana avatishthamanah abhidhyayan tam tam vikaram srujati iti. Meaning that the one who deliberates is Parameshwara and not this element or the devatas in that element. Nor, and there is Parameshwara who creates. So Parameshwara is the one who deliberates, and Parameshwara is the one who creates. The elements neither deliberate nor do they create. Parameshwara, who obtains as their very self. So he deliberates and he creates. Although when he said bhutanam, means tat abhimani devatanam ityartha. When the Shruti says that the element fire deliberated, we should understand that the deity presiding over the element fire, deliberated. So said Siddhanti, Akashadi Shabdehi Na Devata Lakshana. So what the Purupakshi said, when it says Tat Tejah Aikshata, then when the fire deliberated, we should understand the word fire, we should understand the Devata, presiding deity of fire, that's called Lakshana Vritti. We do not take the literal meaning. And the fire is, this is Jahal Lakshana. Altogether, fire is discarded, and in place of that, the Adhishthana Devata is substituted. Therefore, so the Lakshana Nayukta, it is not proper that you should resort to Lakshana Vritti or implied meaning. When the literal meaning is possible, we should not go for the implied meaning. Mukhyarthe badhaka abhavat. It is a badhaka and mukhyartha. If in taking mukhyartha literal meaning, there is a badhaka, there is something that obstructs that meaning. Meaning that meaning does not make sense in that particular context, then only you go for the implied meaning. For example, when you say Gangayam Ghoshah, there is this hamlet on the Ganga. So the Badhaka here. The Ganga means Ganga Pravaha, of the stream of water. Nobody can have a hamlet, or an establishment on the stream of water. So the water is Badhaka for construction of or for the residence of people. Therefore, you give the word stream and go for a related word, the bank of the river. So where the primary meaning does not fit into the context, then you go for the implied meaning. In this case, there is no reason for you to go for implied meaning because the primary meaning is quite okay. So teja means teja. You need not go for anything else. Panchamyascha prakrutitvartha tatra rudataratvat akashat Vayuhu, Vayuhu, Agnihi. In each case, the Panchami is used. Prakrutitvarthaha, that is for the, that shows that they are the cause. Tatra Rudataratvat, because the fifth case is more common or more commonly used for indicating the cause. तथा च अचेतनानां भूतानां कर्तृत्वमेव नास्ति कुतः ईश्वर अनपेक्ष कर्तृत्वम्. Therefore, the insentient entities such as elements cannot have kartrutvam, doership. There is a question of independent kartrutvam, even dependent kartrutvam. The doership itself cannot be there because they are insentient. Kutah Ishvara Anapeksha Kartratvam. Then where is the question of there being the Karta or the creators independent of Ishvara? Yadyapi Devatanam Kartratvam Sambhavati. But we said that by the word elements, you should take the Devata. So Devata as being the conscious being, therefore Kartratva, the doership, creatorship is possible. Tathapi Ishvara Niyamyatva Shravanat. The Shruti says that even Devatas also are ruled by Ishvara. Ch chetananapi na svatantriyam. Therefore, even conscious beings also do not have the freedom. They also do whatever they do as ruled by Ishvara, within the framework of the rules of Ishvara, that conscious beings also can function. Kiyo vacham achetananam bhutanam na svatantrimiti. When the devatas, who are conscious beings, they do not have svatantram or freedom. Meaning that even they also cannot function independent of Parameshwara, then where is the question of this insentient elements having that freedom? This is Tallingat. So, Parameshwara tena tena atmana avatishthamana abhidhyayan tam tam vikaram srujati iti. So, this is our siddhanta, this is our proposition. That Parameshwara, obtaining as the self of those elements, he deliberates and creates the subsequent elements. Kutaha, on what basis do you say? So there, bhutanam svatantra shramanat nasti svavikara svashtav ishvara apekshadi uktatvahat. But we already said that since elements are independent, they do not require Ishvara for creating or deliberating, then why do you say that Ishvara does it? So, sautram hetu madaya vibhajate, the reply is given based on the hetu given in the sutra. Let us read that. Kutaha tallingat tathahi shastram yaf-prithivyam tishthan yaf-prithivya antarah yam-prithivi na veda yasya-prithivi shariram yaf-prithivi mantaro yamayate iti evam jati yakam sa adhyakshanam eva bhutanam pravrittim darshayate. Linga means indicatory mark. Because of those indicatory marks, we say that Parameshwara deliberates and Parameshwara creates. Tathai Shastram. To illustrate, this is what the Shruti says. Yah Prithivyam Tishtan Yah Antaryami, the inner ruler, the Parameshwara. Prithivyam Tishtan, remaining within the Prithivi, within the earth, remaining in the earth. Yah Prithivyah Antarah, who is within the earth. Yam Prithivi Na Veda, whom the Prithivi, the earth, does not know. Yasya Prithivi Shariram, of whom the Prithivi itself is Sharira. Meaning that Antaryami does not require any other body. Prithivi itself becomes a body. Yah Prithivim Antaro Yamayati, who remaining within the Prithivi rules the Prithivi, controls the Prithivi. So Prithivi is what it is because of the inner ruler. In short, the Prithvi is being ruled. Prithvi is not independent. Iti evam jati ekam shastram. This and similar statements of the Shruti. Sa adhyakshanam eva adhyakshena sah vartamanam. So, adhyakshena, adhyaksh means what? The witness. So that presided over by witness. So being adhyaksha also means the one who is presiding over. So therefore, the elements such as prithvi also, pravritti, what the prithvi does, it does as presided over by a conscious being, that is Parameshwara. Meaning that the activity of prithvi are not independent. The Parameshwara resides as Antaryami, as the inner ruler, and rules the prithvi, meaning that whatever prithvi does is according to the rule of the inner ruler, Antaryami. Further Bhashyakara says, Tatha Suhitasya Bhutanam Ayukta Svatantrena Pravrutti. For this further reason also. One reason is what? That Bhutas, elements are not independent. They are ruled by the Antaryami. And further, Suhitasya Bhutanam Ayukta Svatantrena Pravrutti. For this further reason also, we say that the elements do not have independent activity. So Vashyakara says, Tatha Sokamayata Bahusyam Prajaya Iti Prastutya Satchatyacha Bhavata Tadatmanam Swayamakuruta Iti Cha Tasyaiva Cha Sarvatma Bhavam Darshayati. Tatha, furthermore, So Kamayata Saha Akamayata Saha Parameshwara Akamayata, that Parameshwara desired. Bahusyam, may I become many. Prajaya, may I be born. So may I become many. May be born as this universe. That's what the Parameshwara desired or deliberated. So that's important. In the Prastutya. So beginning with this statement, that is Parameshwara who entertained the desire of becoming many and being born. Then Satchatyacha Bhavata, that Parameshwara himself becomes Sat and Tyat. Sat means the three elements, fire, water and earth. Tyat means the other two elements, space and air. Sat means the gross. Tyat means the subtle. Sat means the effect or murta. Tyat means amurta, etc. So sat and tyat, when you add up, then become satyam. So therefore, word satya was given two meanings. One is Vyavaharika Satta, when word Satya is understood as Sat plus Tyat as Satyam, then it means the creation made of five elements, that is Satyam, the truth, that is a Vyavaharika Satya. Then Satyasya Satyam, Ishvara is the Satyasya Satyam, the truth of this truth. So universe is Satyam, truth, and its truth is Paramatma. So this truth is only in fact mithya is called satyam here, because it has some satyam as far as people are concerned. The vyavaharika satya is there, so you can do the vyavahara, that much satyata is there. So satchatyacha bhavata, he himself became sat and tyat. Paramatma himself became this universe of five elements. Niruktam cha, niruktam cha, nilayanam cha, nilayanam cha, vijnanam cha, vijnanam cha, satyat yatcha bhavata. Then tadatmanam swayam kuruta, that Paramatma himself created himself. So Paramatma made himself in the form of this universe. So Paramatma by himself became the universe. Meaning Paramatma is independent in, so Kamayata, he is independent in deliberation and Swameva Akurta means that Sat Atmanam Swameva Kuruta. He independently, he himself, by himself, became this universe. So he is the independently he creates, independently deliberates. Iti cha tasseva sarvatma bhavam darshayati. So these two statements show how Ishvara is sarvatma, the self of all. Satcha tyatcha bhavata, he became sat and tyat. He became the universe of five elements. He became everything, meaning that he is the self of all. Or tadatmanam swamakuruta, he created himself by himself. So he himself became this universe. He is the self of the whole universe. So sarvatma bhavam darshayati. So Lhatna Bhavad said, tattat achetanatmana avasthitasya brahmanah upadanatvepi jiva vyavratta ishvaratva akareneva sakshat sarakartatvam na jivatva dvara tasya sarva niyantratva lingat niyantratva lingaditya. So that was the explanation of ya prithivyam tishtan etc. Tattat achetanatmana avasthitasya brahmanah. Brahman who obtains as the self of prithivi, self of earth, self of fire, self of all these unconscious inert beings. Brahmana upadanatvepi. So Brahma is the upadanam, the material cause for all of them. But that's all right. But then jiva created, devata created, why not? Even Brahma is upadanam, but devata created, taking Brahma is upadanam, says no. Jiva vyavritta ishvaratva akaraneva sakshat sarvakrtutvam. It is not as devata that he is a creator, but as Parameshwara is the creator. Jiva vyavritta ishvaratva akaraneva. Excluding the jiva as Ishvara alone. So that is why yah prithivyamantaro yamayati iti sa adhyakshamana adhyakshanam eva bhutanam pravrutim darshayati. That bhuta's elements have the pravrutti or activity whereas presided over by Parameshwara, by the conscious being. Tasya sarvanyantratvat lingat. So what's a linga here? Lingat means what? Sarvanyantratvat. Because Parameshwara is sarvanyanta. That is why he is a niyanta. So he alone does everything. Even though prithvi may appear to do something, but still it is Parameshwara obtaining as the very self of prithvi. He does. So prithvi may appear to create something. Prithivya oshadaya, the herbs and plants are all created from prithvi. It is Parameshwara obtaining the self of prithvi who does that. So second is prakaranacha sakshat sarvakartatvam prakarana. In the same context of creation, elsewhere in Taittiriya Upanishad, this is what is said. Tatha so kamayata bahusyam prajayati prastutya satcha tyaccha bhavad tadatmanam sam akurta iti ita tasseva cha sarvatma bhavam darshayati. Purvoktam anudya nirasyate. What the Purvapakshiya said, Anudya, reiterating that, restating that, Bhashyakara refused that Yattu iti. Yattu ikshana shravanam aptejasoho tata parameshwara aveshavasadeva drashtavyam nanyo tosti drashta iti ikshitrantara pratishedhad. So tat teja aikshata taha apaha aikshanta. That's what Purvapakshi said, that bhutanavi chetanatva shravanat. From that we conclude that elements also are conscious being. To that Vashyakara replies, yattu ikshana shravanam ap tejasoho. The Shruti says that up or water, tejas or fire, deliberated. Tat parameshvara aveshvasat eva. That is because Parameshvara has entered these elements as their own self. Dastavyam nanya atasi dastayati. That Parameshvara alone does that ikshanam because nanya atasi dasta ata anya dasta nasti. There is no dasta or the seer other than the Parameshvara. Therefore, ikshanam is seeing. Tat aikshata, he saw. But Upanishad says that there is no seer other than Parameshvara. So even though it looks like the element fire saw, in fact it is Parameshvara obtaining as the self element fire that saw or that deliberated. Ikshitrantara pratishedat. Because Upanishad says that only one ikshita is there, one drashta is there, one seer is there, and that is Brahman, that is consciousness, and no one else. So says Ratnavara, Parameshwarasya antare bhavena avesha sambandha Parameshwara aveshat. So Parameshwara obtains as the antaryami of the elements. And that avesha means sambandha, Parameshwara sambandhat. Parameshwara obtains the antaryami of the elements, and because of that, tadvashat, because of that only, bhuteshu ikshanam. So in the elements also, ikshanam, or the deliberation, or seeing is because of the Parameshwara being present there as the antaryami. Naitavada tesham chetanatvam svatantram va. So because of that, you cannot, just because Upanishad is tat tejah aikshata, that element fire deliberated, is no, is only, it means that only Parameshwara deliberated. Therefore, on the strength of that statement, you cannot say that the bhuta, the elements are conscious or independent. Anena tat abhidhyanat idi padam vyakhyatam. So tat abhidhyanat, by deliberation upon tat, by deliberation upon those respective elements. The idea is that deliberation must take place before the creation takes place. So before the creation of element vayu, Ishvara as the element space, or the space, or the self of the space, deliberates upon vayu and then creates vayu. Then Ishvara, obtaining as the self of vayu, deliberates upon fire and creates element fire. Anena tat abhidhyanadi padam vyakhyatam ittam sutrayojana. So the Tikakara explains the sutra. What is sutra? Tat abhidhyanadeva tallingat saha. Tat abhidhyanadeva tu tallingat saha. Saha Ishvara तत्तत् आत्मना स्थितोपि साक्षादेव सर्वकर्ता तस्य अंतर्यामित्वलिंगात्। स ईश्वर तत्तत् आत्मना स्थितोपि द वेरी ईश्वर हू ऑब्टेन्स एज द आत्मा द सेल्फ ऑफ दोज रिस्पेक्टिव एलिमेंट्स साक्षादेव सर्वकर्ता इट इज ईश्वर हू इज डायरेक्टली द क्रिएट नॉट थ्रू somebody. नॉट ईश्वर क्रिएट्स टू भूत नॉट ईश्वर क्रिएट्स टू देवता ईश्वर हिमसेल्फ क्रिएट्स साक्षादेव सर्वकर्ता तस्य अंतर्यामित्व लिंगाद बिकॉज ही इज अंतर्यामी। जीवत्व द्वारा कर्तृत्व नाम to say that Ishvara deliberates or creates to Devata, Devata is also a Jivas. Jiva seva kartatvam iti. In that case, so Jiva becomes a karta, antaryamina, kartatva, asiddhe. Then antaryami is not proven to be the karta. If Devata is a karta, not antaryami. Antaryamitva yoga. The idea is that even when Antaryam is there as a very self, still that Jiva or Devata himself creates. That means that Antaryami does not have the power. If the boss is sitting here, sometimes father is sitting there and the son behaves whatever way he wants, suppose. That means father has no authority. If the figure of authority is there and in presence of that, some assistant or somebody independently behaves, in that case, this is not the authority. Similarly also, if the ruler is sitting there as the very self, in spite of his presence, if Devata or Jiva independently deliberates, independently creates, then that means that he is not the Antaryami. Because even though the ruler is there, this fellow is independently functioning, then rulership itself is not there. Therefore, antaryamitva ayogad. If a jiva or devata deliberates and creates independently, then the Parameshwara no more remains antaryami, the inner ruler. So, tat abhidhyanat, ishvara ikshana deva, tat abhidhyanat. It is the ikshanam, the abhidhyanam, the deliberation, or deep meditation on the part of Ishvara himself. Bhuteshu sutekshana upattescha. Actually, Ishvara obtaining his antaryami deliberates, and by lakshana it says the fire deliberated and the water deliberated. So that is only why. So sudha ikshana upattescha. It is Ishvara deliberates, and Shruti says, because Ishvara is not seen, the inner ruler is not seen. What is seen is fire. And then you see deliberation, therefore, Shruti says, the fire deliberated. We should understand that Ishvara obtaining the self of fire deliberates himself. So that is how you can logically explain the deliberation, the part of the elements, by only understanding that Ishvara obtaining as their self deliberates. Or says Nyanirna, Parameshwarasya Bhuteshu Praveshat Tadiyam Eva Abhidhyanam Ap tejaso upacharyate. Therefore, you must understand this in a secondary sense. That water and fire deliberated is to be taken in the secondary sense, because tas sushtva tadevanu pravishada. The Taittiriya Upanishad says Ishvara, having created the elements, entered the elements. Chandogya also will say, अनेन जीवेन आत्मना अनुप्रविश्य नाम रूपे व्याकरवाणी इति। सो दैट देवता सच सेज दैट as Jivatma, I will enter the three elements and bring to manifestation names and forms. So the manifestation of names and forms is by Brahman directly or Ishvara directly. So when Upanishad says the fire deliberated, unine upacharika, only a secondary sense misunderstand, or what I deliberated in a secondary sense, in primary sense, Parameshvara alone deliberated. Tat na bhutanam chetanatva ashanka ityartha. Therefore, in a secondary sense, so manchaha kroshanti, they say. Manchaha kroshanti, the scaffoldings are screaming. The scaffoldings are screaming. So when you take a walk in the midst of fields in the early morning, then you find that there are scaffoldings on the trees or created scaffoldings where the farmers are sleeping. In the morning they wake up and the birds also wake up and start eating their grains, and so these fellows want to drive them away, and therefore they shout at them. So from every you don't see, what you see the scaffolding, don't see the person sitting in scaffolding. Therefore you say this, you know, manchaha kroshandi, the scaffolding is screaming. When the scaffolding is screaming, it is the person in the scaffolding that is screaming, and that screaming is attributed to scaffolding only in a secondary sense, not in the primary sense, because scaffolding is insentient, it cannot scream. So there must be a sentient or a conscious being in the scaffolding who screams. Again, Nyayanena says, Bhutanam tat abhimani chetana devata dvarena ikshana siddhau kim ishvranita asankhyaha. So bhutanam tat abhimani chetana devata. The Purupakshi says, we said, when we said that the bhuta or elements deliberated, we meant the devata, the presiding deity deliberated. Then why do you bring Parameshwara in there? Why do you bring Parameshwara? Tadabhimani chetana devata dvarena ikshana siddhau. When chetana conscious devata, who is presiding over that element, he deliberates, then kim ishvarena? Then why do you say Ishvara deliberates? In that sense is nanyaha atha asti drashta. Says drashta is only Ishvara, no devata, nobody else. There is only one drashta, one sakshi, one witness, one deliberator everywhere, and that is Parameshwara. So even though devata appears to be deliberating, Ishvara alone is a true deliberator or true seer. Or as Ratnaprabha said, tat tejaha aikshate iti shrutah ikshita paramatma eva. Tat tejaha aikshata, that element fire deliberately shrutah ikshita, that deliberator or seer that the Shruti talks about is paramatma eva, because nanyaha atah asti drashta, there is no drashta or seer other than paramatma anywhere. It's important that everything is done by Parameshwara. Aham sarvasya prabhava mattas sarvam pravartate. Aham sarvasya prabhava, I am the origin of everything. Mattas sarvam pravartate. All the pravarti is because of me. I am the one that prompts all the activities. Yatah pravartir bhutanam yena saram idam tatam. That from whom the pravarti all the activities of all the beings is, and the creation of all the beings is, and one who pervades everything. Says Nyayanirne, Bhavatuva Chetananam Devatatmanam Bhinnatvam Tathapi King Karanamiti Vishaye Parameshwarasya Karanatvena Kluptatvat Seva Dvidha Karanamiti. Bhavatuva Chetananam Devatatmanam Bhinnatvam. Alright, that Devata, who is Chetana, they are different from Parameshwara, okay. Tathapi kim karanam? Still, what is the, who is the karanam? Who is the creator? What's the material cause? What's the efficient cause? Iti vishaye, vishaye means samshaye, Parameshwarasya karanatvena kliptatvat. Already Upanishad said that Parameshwara is a karanam. Saiva dvidha karanam, therefore, he alone is the karanam, both ways, the material and efficient cause. So, prakrutatvat, Bhashyakara says, prakrutatvacha sataha ikshituhu tadaikshata bahusyam prajaya ityatra. Before it says tat teja aikshata, Upanishad said tat aikshata, that devata sat or brahma in fact deliberated bahusyam prajaya, may become many, may be one. So first deliberation is on the part of brahma. So prakrutatvat, so is the deliberator. Brahman is presented as the one who deliberates prakruta, that's under the discussion. So, Parameshwarasya karanatena kluptatvat. Parameshwara already has been determined to be kluptam in nischidam. So, Parameshwara is already determined as the karanam. How? Tada ikshata bahusyam prajaya. The Paramatma deliberated, may become many, means what? The upadana karanam. Prajaya, may be born. And so, basically presented as the upadana karanam, and tad aikshata, that is the nimitta karanam. Because ikshanam is on the part of the conscious being, bahubhavanam or becoming many is the part of the upadana karanam. So in case of the clay and the pot maker deliberates and clay becomes many. One clay becomes many pots and pans. Here on the other hand, Paramatma deliberates, himself becomes many names and forms, so is dvidha karanam. He both ways, as the upadana karanam, material cause, and nimitta karanam, efficient cause both ways, Parameshwara is a karanam. Therefore, says Ratnava, tasmad Ishvara Padartha Lopa Prasangena Ishwarat Anyasya Swatantra Abhavat Na Ishwara Kartutva Shute Bhuta Shrutya Virodayati Siddham. Tasmat Ishwara Padartha Lopa Prasangena. If the Bhutas or anybody starts functioning independently, deliberating independently, creating independently, then there is no Ishwara. By the very meaning, Ishvara means a ruler. One whose nature it is to rule. In spite of ruler being there, if these elements and devatas independently deliberate and independently create, then where is Ishvara? He can't be called Ishvara. So Ishvara padartha lopa prasangena. The word Ishvara itself will have no meaning. Therefore, Ishvara Anyasya Swatantra Abhavat. The word Ishvara itself says that he is a ruler. That means he He is only Swatantra, he is only independent one entity. There is nobody else or nothing else that is independent. Na Ishvara Kartrutva Srutehe Bhuta Srutya Virodha. That was the Shruti which says Ishvara is a Karta, so Kamayata. And this says Tat Tejaha Aikshata, etc. There is no Virodha because everywhere Ishvara alone is a deliberator, Ishvara alone is a creator. Or Nyanena says, Brahmana, Swarupena, Pararupena, Sarvakaranatve. Either Brahman as Brahman creates, or Brahman as space creates, Brahman as Vayu creates. Swarupena, Pararupena, Sarvakaranatve. In any case, Brahman is Sarvakaranam, the cause of everything. Sarva Sastru, Brahma Samanvayasya. So Brahman is Tatpare is what? Brahman is sarvasrashtu. Brahman is creator of everything. And not even via media, through anything, they directly creates everything. As Vayu, but Brahman creates. As fire, Brahman creates. Bhuta svatantra sastutva shruti virodha na. Therefore, even though the shruti seems to say that bhutas create and independently create, that is to be taken only in a secondary sense. By Bhuta, we should understand Ishvara who creates. Therefore, Virodha na iti. So, this is how Siddhanti wants to bring about the Avirodha of the Shruti. The Ekadeshi said that one Shruti is primary, other Shruti is Gauni. That way, he wants to remove the Virodha. But Upanishad Vedantin says both the Shrutis are taken to be primary. And so when you said Bhuta, you should understand as Parameshwara obtaining as the self of that particular element. So there is no Virodha at all. So there is no contradiction, inner contradiction between this Shruti statement. Therefore, Shruti remains Pramanam. And everywhere, Brahman is the creator, Brahman is the seer, etc. In this manner, in all these sutras, the topic of the five elements and the creation has been dealt with. And that way, this one topic is concluded here. There are some other sutras also that we have to study. But in fact, we are studying only Chandogya Upanishad, understand? What we are studying are the statements of Chandogya Upanishad only. And this sutra and bhashya, in fact, elaborately explain those statements only. So this is, on one hand, the study of Brahma Sutra, on the other hand, the study of Chandogya only, you should understand that. So we are not departing from our main topic, you know, when we do the Brahma Sutra. So we'll continue tomorrow also with Brahma Sutra. We'll go to the right beginning. We go to the fifth sutra of the first chapter. First quarter, 115. Ikshatehe Nashabdam. That's a sutra which talks about the creation based on this Upanishad only. On the page 100, beginning from page 100 of this book, the sutra is on page 102, Ikshatehe na ashabdam. So that's what it says. Na means what? The pradhanam is not the cause. Ashabdam because pradhana is not mentioned by the Upanishads. Ikshatehe, because of ikshanam, that it is a conscious being and not some unconscious or insentient being such as pradhanam. But very elaborate arguments are given there because the Sankhyas want to interpret, because they use the pronouns of sadeva samvidam. What is sat? Sankhya say that what the Upanishad means by the word sat is pradhanam. That's what the Sankhyas want to say. And Vedantins want to clarify that Sat means Brahman. So that will be the next line of discussion here. We'll continue from tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ॐ।